All right, welcome to round three. Still recovering from the punt from the last one. Such punts. Gotta play the turn one map with the land. You gotta give yourself outs. All right, this might be dredge. It could be anything, it could be burn. Temple Garden. Okay, so I guess elves. Well, I guess we should, yeah. So here, what you wanna do is you wanna Ancient Stonings before you map, because we have eight different cards we were looking for. If we map first, we only have four ways to hit Tron. I know it's common sense, but I just felt like I should point it out at least. Also, we're very unlikely to hit. Given our luck. All right, so we got the Tron land here. And pass. All right, so we have a turn four Ugin, which isn't terrible. Actually, this is really nice. Assuming our opponent is on like the Elf Ball deck, the fact that we can crack our expedition map next turn to get our Tron piece for Ugin, and then on top of that be able to play Path to Exile, means that we're very, very unlikely to die. All right, what you got? Elvish Archdruid. I will allow a turn to Elvish Archdruid. Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot. I know a lot of people get upset at the comments when I forget about people making comments in the corner. I just focus so hard on my match and the commentary that I sometimes do forget. So it's not like I'm doing it intentionally. I just sometimes it passes. You know, sometimes I just don't think about it. Uh-oh. This is much worse for me. My opponent doing this, much worse for me. Oh my god. All right. We're going to cast Path to Exile on Disarbor Elf. That's what we're going to do during my opponent's upkeep, because I think there's not a whole lot they can do at instant speed, but I don't want to give them the extra land, because if I Path main phase, they're gonna have access to 3, 4, 5, 6, so they could cast the Primeval Titan. I mean, I don't exactly know what my opponent's playing. I'm really hoping that I don't get severely punished here, but a Utopia Sprawl deck, I'm thinking this is likely like a Tooth and Nail deck or something, so I'm hoping that I don't get Summoning Breached or something. Might as well give them one last draw, like a collective company. I don't exactly know what they're playing, but. All right, here we go. Summoning Trap. Summoning Trap for Primeval Titan and something or another. Oh, God. Oh, no. Why me? You know what I should do? I should just make sure all my removal spells are sorcery speed, so I just can't mess it up. You know, Nature's Claim, sorcery speed. Path to Exile, sorcery speed. Just so I can't mess it up. Just so that it's Cheon proof. Oh god. The only Utopia Sprawl deck that I know that's very popular is the red-green land destruction deck. But my opponent fetched a Temple Garden, so I'm really confused. This is where, you know, 15 people right in the comment section. Well, Paul, obviously he's playing this thing with the stuff. Wow. I can't believe I'm watching this content. Oh no. It is a collected company. What the? Why? You know what's really weird about that, though? Is You would think that a deck that plays Collected Company would favor playing Mana Elves to Utopia Sprawls. And I'm hoping that my opponent got punished and had a Utopia Sprawl in their company. Still not exactly sure what my opponent is on. Except drawing bed. As I misclick. One of my most famous misclicks is what I like to call the headset punt, where I had exactly one out to basically draw Tron, I believe, or Ugin. It was something like that. I needed to either draw Ugin or Tron, and I did. I was against Jund. Liliana was going to ultimate. I got super excited, and like a Munson, I tossed my headset onto my desk, did a circle around my room, you know, did a little flex, and then went back to my computer to, you know, cast my Ugin, only to find out that my headset had landed on my F6 button, and I had passed my turn when I drew my one out for the win. That was not good times. But you know what? That's justice. Doing a little showboating like that. That's just justice. I deserve it. Okay, so this doesn't get company. So Nature's Claim is an interesting one. The only reason why I would consider bringing in Nature's Claim here is because they could bring in Stony Silence. We did just lose to it. On top of that, they do play Utopia Sprawl. So it's not going to be totally dead. It doesn't look like my opponent's deck is aggressive enough where I really care about Thragtusk. I feel like this package of win conditions is likely good enough. Not really a huge fan of Blessed Alliance here. They're not super aggressive. So I think maybe I just bring in two Nature's Claims and just keep everything else the way that it is. Pretty happy with everything else. Whew. If only I had a couple of lands in it. Yeah, I'm gonna keep this. Wow. Lucky Cheon. As long as we don't get turn two Stony Silenced. If we get turn two Stony Silenced, we're drawing dead. So dead. Just got a jam though. If my opponent goes like turn two Pride Mage or whatever, then sure, that's unfortunate, but because they can turn two Pride Mage and fire it off, but I want to play this turn three Karn. Can't play turn three Karn without playing the turn one map. I guess I could, just if I'm insanely lucky. The thing is, even if my opponent kills my map, I can still go Sphere into Ancient Stirrings, which doesn't give me a great chance to hit. I don't know what the numbers are. Maybe 10%, 15% to hit my fourth Tron piece. Somebody can run the numbers. Don't do it. Don't do it. It's a Stony Silence. Nope, no, it's a Knight of the Reliquary. Okay. Okay. So this is exactly what I meant, by the way. If we don't find that land, we won't be able to play a turn 4 Ugin. The Razor Verge Thicket here. What if my opponent just plays like the coral thing, retreat to something or another. I wonder how many ghost quarters are in their deck. All right, well, that kind of changes things. I guess I don't really need to search until later. Getting some beatdowns here. ahead and get the power plant. Let's go with ancient stirrings. Please? Oh. Any order? Play that, play this, and hope. At this point, all we can do is hope. If my opponent goes fetch land into something or another, I mean, I guess we could still find a white source off my Chromatic Sphere. Also, if my opponent just has a second Ghost Quarter, that's also bad. And it wouldn't surprise me if my opponent did play two Ghost Quarters. Like, when you're playing Knight of the Reliquaries, having a second Ghost Quarter, at least like in the sideboard, it's not an unreasonable thing. At the same time, if my opponent just attacks me for 10, if my opponent just attacks me for 10 and has Collected Company in hand, I'm pretty likely dead. I guess now they can attack me for 12. They can attack me for 12, get me down to 3, and just keep up company. Even if I Ugin, it's not going to be good enough. I could find an Oblivion Stone. That would be ideal. Again, this is all assuming my opponent doesn't have a Ghost Quarter. Man, if we were on the play, we would have been so good. A Utopia Sprawl? Okay. I feel like my opponent could have put that on the Temple Garden. Or tap Temple Garden and put it on the forest. Those seem better. Tapped. That is very good for me. You know what? I'm going to crack this for white. If I draw a path, okay. We're at 2 life. We have 1 play. All right. We're at 2 life. There's a Stomping Ground on the board. No Lightning Bolt. I'm assuming Stomping Ground is for like a singular copy of Kessig Wolf Run. Did not count what could have witnessed for Ghost Quarter. Okay, yeah, that would have certainly done it. Yes. All right. 2, not 0. Not 0. She's just playing against mid-range decks all day. I'll take it. No burn, please. No more burn.